start with a little bit of breathing. Place your feet comfortable distance apart, hands on the lower abdomen. Lips lightly sealed, teeth gently meshed together. Allow your eyes to close and begin transitioning your thoughts and your breath from whatever we were doing before this into our Tai Chi class. And go through your own cascade of relaxation from the top of your head down through the body to the bottoms of your feet, checking in to find out where you might be storing excess, unnecessary tension, and invite it to dissipate and relax. Breathe in deeply, breathe out slowly, be relaxed. Once you feel centered, sometime between now and the next 60 seconds, go ahead on your own and transition into a bracing horse. palms up. Inhale, slowly press the palms down to exhale. Okay, so if I understand correctly, focused on a little bit of review up through Fair Lady Work Shuttle's first corner, the first one, and then we split groups and advanced, ran the whole third section, intermediates, worked on the second corner.
Correct.
Yes. Got it. All right, so let's do that again. Let's run it together as a group from cross hands through the first corner once. The second time, we're going to run it from cross hands through all four corners just to kind of lay out the sequence, and then we'll split groups again and we'll go from there. All right?
Yes, ma'am.
Embrace tiger, return to mountain. Grasp the bird's tail. Diagonal, single whip. Part the wild horse's mane once. Part the wild horse's mane two. Part the wild horse's mane three. Grasp the bird's tail towards the front. Pull back and press. And push. Single whip. Four corners, transition, Fair Lady Work Shuttles, one. Good, release. Do that one more time, and we'll go through all four corners, and then I'll answer questions, demonstrate, and then we'll split. Thank you. Embrace tiger, return to mouth. Grasp the bird's tail. Diagonal, single whip. Part the wild horse's mane one. Part the wild horse's mane two. Part the wild horse's mane three. Grasp the bird's tail. Ward off left towards the front. Ward off right towards the office. Pull back, press, and push. Single whip. Four corners. Wind up. Fair Lady Work Shuttles, one. New to you, just wing it. Fair Lady Work Shuttles, two. So I'm going to be stepping back with my right, lifting with the rest. Fair Lady Work Shuttles, three. Here, I'm just going to step that way. Left hand up. And Fair Lady Work Shuttles, four is identical to number two. Step back with the right. Shift and lift. Yep. are new, but any questions or anything you'd like to see about them before we split? Anything?
Just going to the four shells. Hands.
Okay. Okay. I kind of pre-phrased this in Master's Path Day class that because 1, 2, and 4 are super complicated, we want to make 3 more complicated, even though it's just a ball of them, just step that way. So, what do my hands do? See the switch? So, I'm here. As I shift back, I bring them down. And then as I sink and step, that's when I transition and put the left hand on top. You see what I'm doing?
Mm-hmm.
So then if
I'm doing this, that's not right.
Right, at first just lower them. So if the right hand is up, I lower that to just how it was before I got there. Mm-hmm. And then as I shift my weight, I switch them. So I go from here to here. Turn and face me. There you go. So I reset. So they come down. And then as I sink down, step in. I change them. You got it?
Yes.
So it's just here, back down,
to this elbow.
And then whoop. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So as you sink down, baby. Hold the baby.
So yes. So I'm holding this baby and then I change my grip to the baby over here. Yeah. So three-dimensionally, holding the baby is a really good analogy. If that's too three-dimensional, which it is for somebody, my hands are roughly making sort of a T. So you can hear it described both as holding a baby or making a T with my arms, whichever is more accessible to where you are in space. The concept is the same. But holding the baby gives that good palm ward-off energy that these moves embody. Did that help?
Yes.
Yay. Okay. Any other questions? That was a good one. Okay. Advanced. Have this half of the room run the third section. I will check in, and then we will do some corners over here. So, did he get you in corner 2? Corner 1. Good time. All right. So, let me see if I can, just so I can kind of see where to start from single whip, and then 4 corners, which is what we usually say to get that transition. Yeah, and then Fair Lady Book Shuffles 1. Nice. Okay. The only little thing that's missing is that, you know how we can turn around, try to back this, turn one way, and then you turn the other way? Same thing happens here. So if I'm in single whip, I lower, I turn here.
Oh, that's right.
And then I turn here, which is what allows me then. Okay, transition. So 4 corners. That's the shift back, lower the hands, turn to the left, right hand over the left, and then turn back to the right. There you go. Lift the hands, sink down, step in, shift and lift. Very good. Any questions about that?
Is that that's the hands too quickly?
Can I just see?
Yes.
You turn left and right again?
Of course. Let's go up here for the 5 people on the camera.
Okay, hit the left, left and right. And I see you're folding too.
Yes.
I remember some of us are folding, but I forget that.
And yes, so folding takes the pressure off the legs. Because it can be a little uncomfortable or easy to tweak a knee in this if you don't fold. So for you, there's a little more time you spend like to step. So. This looks good. This looks good. This looks good. But from here, you're kind of just going straight. And perfect world. You're here. You're each this leg so that you can be balanced.
Okay, so for a long presentation.
A little bit of a presentation.
Okay.
I mean, when you strip, smooth it together, less so. But when you're learning it, this is a really important place to be able to be so that I can sit down and step in and do my balance. And then step out. So do it. Yes.
I'm asking step out. How are your feet aligned?
Yeah, that's a little bit of a problem.
I'm still struggling.
Yeah. What happens quite frequently is this foot doesn't get turned out enough, so it goes to here, and then you step
back.
Too much.
And I want to be that.
I don't remember that.
There's two sets of tractions. This is the first one.
This is the first one? Okay. Sorry.
Yeah, same one.
And then when you get stuck, release the back feet and shift more into the front, and you can turn those toes out a little more. Yeah, it's like you spill your swing in one foot. Yes. Turn those toes out a little bit more. There you go. That's good.
I'm sure I can.
Sit down a bit and then step out. Yes. Yes.
And I feel good.
That looks pretty good.
I feel good.
You can turn those, now you can turn those toes just a tiny bit more. There you go. And then you're basically toes here on the arch here. So that's correct.
It feels good.
Good.
I don't know what the difference was before and now. I think it's the toes.
It's the toes. But if you don't unstick this foot, you can't get to the toe. So it's this like.
Right.
You know how it's looking.
You don't clear it,
you're
right in the world.
The turning with it. It's the same principle.
So as you get
under, over, over, and you're doing that. Those
bingo.
Sinks. It's the same kind of concept. I mean, empty one into the other one.
Front.
Yeah.
Back to.
Let's try it together a couple times. Here. Goes in. Turn. And see here, I don't just turn. I put more weight in this foot so that I can turn this foot out. Then when I'm going to run out of room, have a big glute, and I want to turn those toes out more so I release the heel. There you go. Excellent. Yes. Sit down, step in, get balance. And then step. Yes. Very good.
And then come to fold.
Good.
I remember you were telling us that
Tuesday.
Tuesday. Monday.
You
it was like, I couldn't feel it.
That looks correct.
Yeah.
You
all right, start over.
Okay.
Now we can start the
okay.
All
right.
Make it happen.
Make it happen.
So here, See, now I have to like scoop my heel.
Move her leg now.
Then I'm gonna sink down, step in, back where my hands change.
Yeah.
Here, here. So now I'm stepping in. Now step back with my heel.
Sweep.
Turn, shift.
There.
Lift.
Okay.
Okay, so if I interpret it right, that leg is pivot all the way around.
This one?
Right.
Goes all in and.
But there's a move after single foot.
I guess we're up here and for me, I'm just gonna start with.
And then front one cuts right and then step.
And then steps back.
But not straight back, slightly left, so that should be enough.
I mean, we're very much like embrace tiger return mount.
That's what creates this.
I think I know that.
Yeah. Because what happens is the toe is not in, it sends you off on the wrong angle.
That's what creates the turn.
Oh, let's work on it. So let's try it together first, all of it, and then we'll work on the finer points. So we'll get into the little chair leg, which is one. So first you're gonna, shift back with your other hand. And you're gonna put your weight on that right leg so you can turn and fold a little bit. That'll help you get some weight out of it, so that you can turn those toes in, and if you need to, cheek the heel. I'll work on it, I'll get it, I'll figure it out if you want to. Then step to even, switch hands. So now my right hand is under the baby's head. So I'm gonna lead with the heel. The right heel. I'm gonna stay on that left leg so I can turn the right toes out.
Yeah.
Then I'm gonna shift.
Alright, high fours.
Yes.
First kick.
So we can talk about my kids.
And I'm gonna watch, so I can see.
Roger, you see what's in back of us.
What's happening? So, what's,
It's a little bit complicated.
It is complicated, and that was just your second time doing it, so let's.
Yeah.
Make third if we got. But, so, get into fair lady work shuttles, one. That's a better angle. Now, let's see. So shift back.
It's helping.
Lower the hands, turn the left toe.
Yeah, trust me, dear.
Yes, that's better. Now, if you need to, cheek that heel. So you'll be more, the front foot doesn't look very happy either. Let's see, there you go.
And now can you do more than that first time?
Yes. There you go. Now step to even, because you don't stay there long.
Do what?
Step back.
Sword form.
And then step back with the heel.
Presentation.
Yep, stay on that left foot. So yes, there you go, turn these toes out. Then shift. And then lift, and you'll be right hand up. That's clear, isn't it? That was terrible. And that folding that he talks about is also what allows your legs to look and do those kind of weird pretzel-y things. So it takes your upper body weight off of your legs. Because if I'm stacked on top of it, it feels terrible. So, first thing, I want to make sure I'm in good alignment here. Because if I'm too much here, it doesn't work. So I want to be in my double dragon flag. And I'll shift. Notice, look where I'm at. I'm here, I'm not here. Mm-hmm. And then sink down, step in, step even.
All small.
And then you're going to stay on that left leg. So do not shift into the right leg yet. Step back with the heel, the right heel, leading with the heel. Stay on that left leg so I can turn the toes out, run into the drum, shift, and lift. And then turn your left toes in a little bit. Very good. Yeah.
It was good until I looked.
Another thing that might happen is shorten your step a little bit will help you get that foot in. Because if you're too wide, it doesn't matter what I do, I can't do it. So if you shorten the distance between front and back foot, you'll probably have more room. Yes, see how that is? And then you can adjust your heel. Yeah. And that's it, that's the, there it is. Yeah.
Yeah.
That was too long of a.
No, that's okay. I really have to work on this. The reason probably has to do with the stay in the Holocaust hospital as a kid.
Oh, Oh, yes, yes.
Signs.
Sure. So just listen to your body.
He was hell trying to turn this right.
But you did it, yeah? Did you get it?
Yeah, I got it. It was nice.
So do you have enough practice for a few minutes while you're taking a walk?
Yes, absolutely.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. How goes it with the exam?
You have those before you do the last snake creep, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Snake creeps down kind of sets up, the second snake creeps down sets up sort of like the home stretch.
Mm-hmm.
Because then that from there, that step up seven stars, which
right.
then sets you up to sweep the lotus. Uh-huh.
And so,
oh, so it's pound my horse. Piercing palm.
Piercing palm.
Then turn the cross horse stick.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And then it's brush and punch your body. And then I always
think I did it backwards. I think
it's punch the ball
and
then back. Any questions about moves in particular? Anything you'd like to see or have any?
Run the form with this, please.
Run the form with you, okay? All right. With names or just from?
Just from. You are good. Yes.
No, other names. I request names. So,
okay.
Embrace that. Here, return to mountain. I'm going to do a, not a fast clip, but a, you know, grasp the bird's tail. A sequence clip, not a meditative clip. Diagonal single whip. Barkerball versus main one. Barkerball versus main two. Barkerball versus main three. Grasp the bird's tail. Single whip. Four horns. Fair lady, work shovels. One.
Not sure what I think, but
fair lady, work shovels. Two. Fair lady, work shovels. Three. Shows. Grasp the bird's tail. Single whip. Golden rooster and one left leg. Golden rooster and one right leg. The pulse monkeys, one. The pulse monkeys, two. The pulse monkeys, three. Slant the fly. Lift hands. White cranes for twins. Brush me first.
in the hand flash. Grasp the wrist down. Single whip. Pat high horse. Piercing palm. Turn body. Cross form together. Push knee, punch to groin. Grasp the bird's tail. Step back, ride the tiger to the mountain. Sweep lotus. Bend bow, shoot up. Hidden hand punch. Withdraw and push. Cross hands. He doesn't want to kung fu fast.
Oh.
Have you ever seen him do his cross and his super lotus? Where he's like, takes him 5 minutes to get from.
Yeah.
It's going to take 5 minutes, but make sure you get some practice of, you know, slowly manipulating that foot across, even if it's not quite as high. The slow balance. Practice of both ways, is what I'm saying. So you've got it.
Mm-hmm.
Now see if you can slow that down to a Tai Chi pace so that it's not slow, 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 quick. Slow, slow, slow. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Any questions? How was it for you?
Good. There's only a couple of transitions that I didn't remember.
Cool.
That had a hidden hand punch where it didn't belong.
It's him. It hit.
Right?
Yeah. All right.
Yeah,
so
that could be the punch down.
Yeah.
Miss the punch down and go straight into the thin hand punch.
Well, it does it on purpose. It makes them sort of similar to but not the same as you go on. So it's how it's good for your brain as well as your body.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. It just gets more complicated and a little bit. Just change that one thing. It's like that other one, but no, it changed a word, you know, versus the whole thing. So
and it's not as low as you go down, it's not to the right, you go back to the left.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
That's the second part.
Yes. Yeah. So you got some practice.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Go check
on.
To work on.
Go check on that. Have you given up?
No, I think I had a little bit of a break.
You did. Tell me about it.
So I get into this if I'm actually shorter and farther out.
Uh huh.
Then cross.
What?
Look at that. Yep.
Right.
So
these
it's two hands
out,
so you'll be at this angle.
Huh?
Yeah.
Is it two hands?
Yeah. Yes. I mean, well, yes, it's just like
correct.
A crescent kick, but as you come around,
very good.
Yeah.
It's just,
bring it up.
I do right,
yes,
right hand only.
Very good.
And the second one is two hands.
Okay.
The one going the other direction.
Yeah.
The sweep blows is two hands.
Hmm?
Turning my toes is
this one here as you come around.
Well, they're turning a little bit.
Choke
little
that
first.
Knee up. Real good. Then
yes.
You can do both.
As I'm actually turning.
Yeah, not good.
Yeah, that's probably not good for balance.
No, it's not good for balance, and it's not good for substantial and substantial. So, yes, I just,
I am not discounting the fact that.
Hello, it's right.
This does not feel particularly balanced. I know.
Yeah.
Just know that as you get more comfortable with this move, this becomes a little easier to hang out in for this.
Well, it's kind of like you said, it wasn't comfortable at first.
Yes, but it, I mean, it is kind of normal, so cost plus.
Right, that would hurt.
Good, just turn those back toes in a little bit.
No, it's not the boat.
I'm going to close the other direction, I'm sorry.
Easy one.
No, it's always that direction.
Just the same.
And then make it smaller here too. So if I'm doing a short one here,
choking that knee.
Make it short as you step back.
And as you land, you automatically.
What I want to do is I want to.
Well, of course, but you hear us say that the way to big is to get small first. And then, yes, it will get large.
Into this.
I have an intuitive grasp of the option.
Push.
And then it will be that much more awesome.
Awesome.
Huge.
Try it small, see how it feels.
Yes, yes, yes. So.
Just notice.
Yeah. And then I'm going to give you a little bit of a tip that might help.
Walk through.
It might not, but it might.
Come through, walk through it, step across.
Good, Mr. Robinson.
Turn here.
That's the business, that's it. And then for me, right, you put your back on your left leg so that you can turn these front toes out. And then there's the funny part. Now shift and then turn the toes. Yes.
Right in between the punch.
So Mr. Gohring, he would do some fine correction on this move with us. Even black sash and beyond is, I would hear him say, shift, don't turn, shift, don't turn yet, shift, don't turn, lift, down, turn. Okay, so I'm going to show you how that applies.
Yeah, okay.
So I always wind up here, give me, so. Shift, don't turn, shift, then lift, and then turn. So it isn't a turning. It looks like it when it's moved out, but I'm shifting, lifting, and turning.
It's a bit like the pressure you push.
Yes, only it's blocking up and pushing out. But yes, that's the same principle. And so my power, I push, so my shift is the lift. And then as this hip comes in,
That's the
push. So when you smooth that out, the whole thing looks like it's rotating into it. But sequentially, I'm taking shift, lift, turn. For me, that helped me anchor balance-wise into those moves. Because I felt much more rooted and stable as I lifted and shifted. I mean, I feel pretty, it's nice, no one's pushing around here. I feel really set.
Yeah.
Which then helps me, and I'm on the drum again. Same thing, particularly here. This one's real easy to turn into a bag. Don't turn. Shift, lift, turn. See the difference? But on this one in particular, it's really easy to turn and lift all at the same time. But if you can keep those things in sync, it'll change the way it feels. And it will help your balance.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Try a couple times. You need to muscle the feet. Think about shift. Shift down, turn. Lift, now turn. But you can hear him, right? You can hear him going, yes, shift, down, turn.
Right. Crosswalk, yeah. That's this up. Yeah.
Good. Good advance. Very good. And turn.
That's one piece of this thing we do now, because you made me do that for like 3 days.
Here you go.
The only thing I'm running this was on the first one.
And then lift and then turn. There you go. Because
so
that
from
should,
here,
in point of view, or a little
tighter. Get that knee high enough.
Tighter more, so your hip has room to turn. Yes. Yeah, it's
pressing the kick, right?
Yeah, it's pressing the
kick. It comes in.
How are you doing back?
Any last questions about this?
No,
obviously, we're going to take this.
Yeah,
we have a 2 week break.
It's actually a wood.
We will keep after this when we come back. So. Yes, very good.
Yeah.
Good.
Practice some of those important
things. Very good. I hope you recognize that, you know, this was. Look at you.
the seat part.
That's good.
I don't know if you know this.
It's okay, but you didn't fall.
Yes.
Ting?
Ting.
All right, any questions before we bow out with our life skill? Obviously, we're gonna have a 2-week break, so, you know, practice if you can, but it is a break. It's a break, like, so, you know, I'm not gonna be running my form every day. If I need a break, so that I can be fresh for you when I come back. Yes, ma'am?
Chris.
Yes?
We're bringing our cup.
Yes.
And floor.
Yes.
Yeah, yes. It's not sprayed up.
No, it is not. If you can, it does have it's a crescent.
It's a crescent.
Yeah. Obviously, different flexibilities and whatnot, you know, that's the goal, is to get it all a full arc, but if you can't, you know, think about it, stay balanced. If you can only get here to here, that's okay.
Right.
And then with time and balance and practice, you should be able to lift it and get it a little higher. I will say sinking and sitting, kind of sitting back into it will help give you room for the leg to do its thing. Yeah, very good. It's very difficult if you're way high up in it. Mm-hmm. But yes, you know, practice, but don't make it, you know, a chore. Find stuff that you'd like to practice, run through it a few times just to keep your body nimble, and know that we will keep working on this stuff when we come back after the break. All right, life skill, persistent action. Path of self-mastery requires persistent action. Persistent action achieves the goal without quitting. The path of self-mastery requires persistent action achieves the goal without quitting. The path of self-mastery requires persistent action. The persistent action achieves the goal without quitting.